So Ayyub alayhi salam, throughout these 18 years, he was devout, he was righteous, he was obedient, and he was patient. And the only thing he would do is call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove away his predicament. But how soon did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer his dua? 18 years into his suffering. And how often that we fall into a situation, or we suffer from a situation, and we want Allah's help immediately. We call upon Allah and we say, "Oh Allah, get me out of this situation now. Now." And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't necessarily respond in the way we wish. Then we start having what? Bad thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me tell you, Allah doesn't work for us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not work according to our whims and desires. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not do things according to our plans. Why? Because our plans, our desires, our wishes are based on our understanding and our knowledge. And all of that is limited. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala acts based on His infinite knowledge that has encompassed everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala acts upon His mercy that has showered everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala acts upon His wisdom that knows the outcomes of everything. That's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to our dua. And how often we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something and it's not good for us. Maybe it has some good in it, but we don't see the other side of it that is far more damaging and far more detrimental. And then we start accusing the mercy of Allah. We start doubting the wisdom of Allah. And we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to act based on our desires and our wishes and our short-sightedness. But Ayyub alayhi salam did not complain about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He just turned to Allah and he said, "Rabbi inni massaniya ash-shaytanu binusbin wa adhab." He said, "Oh Allah, I've been touched by evil." And shaitan has increased that evil, as the scholars say, by shaitan trying to whisper doubts into his heart about his predicament and about the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not relieved him out of that illness sooner. So he complained to Allah that he wants Allah to help him not to allow shaitan to whisper such evil thoughts into his mind. And he never complained about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He would just ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove his illness and to fix his situation. And he never lost hope. He never lost hope for 18 years. Some of us, if it's just a couple of days, we are in a certain situation, we start doubting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We start thinking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't care about us. Or we think Allah doesn't listen to us. Or we think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't know what's good for us. And these are serious doubts that are exacerbated by shaitan, and we should be careful about that. Because ultimately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala acts based, as we said, on His infinite knowledge and His powerful mercy and His deep wisdom. So we have to trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, we make dua and we have hope in Allah, and we don't lose hope in Allah no matter how long it takes. And yes, we act to improve the situation. We do everything within our capacity to make the situation better. If that works, alhamdulillah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought goodness through our actions and our determination. If it doesn't work, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a better choice for you. We have to work on these two parallel paths. One is complete and utter trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that whatever He brings about, whatever He allows to unfold, is going to be best for us. We should not lose touch with that kind of notion and belief. We should hold on to it and embrace it and never let go of it. And on the other path, we are supposed to do everything within our capacity to try to understand what is better for us and work towards it and do everything necessary and legitimate in order to arrive at it. And whether that happens or not, we leave that with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.